Welcome to see so many young faces full of energy and enthusiasm. Friends, you have just learned, you have just told about IST activities and you are aware of the achievements of JEC. This institute has been in the forefront of IST activity last time and has been amply verified by a number of awards it has received in the past few years. I shall not be speaking on formally defined themes and topics. I shall be talking to you in a heartfelt manner about some mundane topics. Dr. Sir Moksh Gurnam Vishwasraiya, he was Bharat Ratna, he was original Bharat awardee in our country. Someday you might learn about him, report about him. If not, try to learn about him. He was a very, very great man of country. Many of his comments, achievements are worth remembering and recalling to young engineers. He said, "Work well, earn well, and live well. Work well, earn well, and live well." I was talking on these topics. US but engineers have all to work well. You shall earn well, and I hope we shall live well also. How to work well? Engineers are basically creators. All the construction activities, bridges, roads, highways, townships, all the factories, all the consumer products, all the communication devices, and many more things of social needs are the results of creativity of engineers, somebody like you. You also aim to become creators of society so that country progresses. You become happy, your family in turn becomes happy, and society gets benefited from your contribution. How? There are two or three requirements for that. Number one, you have very wisely chosen this profession. In our country, rather throughout the world, employment is a big problem. You might be reading papers that to fill a vacancy of 100 persons in banks, there will be 10,000 applicants. Buses, workflow, trains, workflow by the applicants, casualties occur. For every post, there may be hundreds of applicants. Where in engineering, there may be, for every post, there may be 3 or 4 or maybe 5 applicants. So it is comparatively easier to get jobs in engineering. But there is a big but here. Only those get jobs who are competent, who prove themselves to be better than the other three, other four. And what is required for that? First and foremost, your academic competence. And for that, you have to be very regular, punctual, hardworking, perseverant, sincere, and respectful to teachers. Try to learn everything taught in classes. Lecture classes, lab classes, tutorials, industrial training, so that you become academically competent. That's one thing. When after getting degree, you apply somewhere, you are called for some personal interaction by way of interview or GD or maybe some other test, you are tested for your personal caliber. Your mark sheet is only a sort of ambassador for you. By seeing mark sheet, you are called for interview. So after acquiring good marks, good theoretical and practical knowledge, you are tested for suitability for the post. You are after getting a job, whereas employer are looking after they are looking after suitability to meet their requirement. Whether you will fulfill their needs. They want persons who can not only just meet the day-to-day requirement, who can contribute to the progress of the company. The company has got turnover of 1 crore this year. They expect to expand it, enlarge it to 2 crores, 3 crores, 4 crores next year. And that is done by engineers. Engineers must be competent, hardworking, loyal, and productive. So you have to be that also. And for that, besides the academic requirements, the personal requirements, your ability to communicate effectively, ability to lead others, ability to work in team, having good body language, having good cheerful personality, all these matter. And that can be partly, or maybe to some substantial extent, learned through activities like this. Extracurricular activities. NIST has been trying to impart students through its various chapters these qualities. I hope we shall keep on taking interest in these activities, curricular, co-curricular, extracurricular, so that you can develop your personality, to enrich yourself, to become not only suitable, but best person to any employer. And to that end, I extend my best result to all of you. You prosper well. You acquire everything required in life for your benefit, for your family, happiness of family. All the best to you.
Board of Technical Education, Jodhpur, Rajasthan. So please come and stimulate the law spirit of the students.
सभी अतिथिगण और आपका स्वागत करता हूं। देश और दुनिया के सामने ऊर्जा का संकट एक बड़ा सरदर्द बन चुका है। ऊर्जा के ज्ञात प्रदूषणकारी समस्त संसाधनों का हम बेहद दोहन कर चुके हैं और इस प्रक्रिया में न केवल ऊर्जा संकट बल्कि ग्लोबल वार्मिंग के जरिए पृथ्वी के अस्तित्व पर ही बड़ा प्रश्न चिन्ह खड़ा कर चुके हैं। आईएसटी राजस्थान सेक्शन वे जेईसी चैप्टर देश और दुनिया की ऐसी समस्याओं के प्रति हमेशा संवेदनशील रहे हैं और ऐसे संगठनों के तकनीकी सांस्कृतिक एवं सामाजिक समाधानों पर बड़ी लगन से चिंतन मनन एवं अनुपालन की दिल से कोशिश करते हैं। इस कड़ी में इस स्टूडेंट कन्वेंशन का आयोजन किया जा रहा है। मैं समझता हूँ कि हम सबका ये प्रयास ऊर्जा संकट के समाधान में एक महत्वपूर्ण भूमिका अदा करेगा। के साथ में आईएसटी राजस्थान सेक्शन ने स्टेट में एक बड़ी मुहिम चलाई हुई है एनवायरनमेंट कंजर्वेशन की, एनवायरनमेंट अवेयरनेस की, और उसी कड़ी में आज का ये जो है कन्वेंशन का मेन थीम है एनर्जी के ऊपर आधारित। तो मैं उम्मीद करूँगा कि इन दो दिनों में हमारे विद्यार्थी और शिक्षकगण इन समस्याओं के समाधान में और ख़ास तौर से क्या किया जाना चाहिए वो हम करके दिखाएंगे। आज करके दिखाने की बारी है। भाषण तो पूरी दुनिया में दिए जाते हैं लेकिन आईएसटी राजस्थान सेक्शन और हमारे चैप्टर्स जो है उन जो है विचारों को अमली जामा पहनाने में अहम भूमिका अदा करेंगे। इन्हीं शब्दों के साथ में मैं आप सभी को शुभकामनाएँ देता हूँ और उम्मीद करूँगा कि हम जो है आईएसटी के माध्यम से दुनिया को ऐसे संकटों से निजात दिलाने में अग्रणी भूमिका निभाएंगे। धन्यवाद।